We welcome you to the family, people, the Ogono Art family. So I'm going to be doing a proportions tutorial on proportions. So yeah, well, it will be focused on proportions, but it won't be on, you know, anatomy, because that's another different ball game. I feel that, you know, for now, for like if you're starting out, or if you're new to the arts, you should focus on proportions, and then, you know, once you have that done and figured out, you can go on to the other things like anatomy and all that other stuff. And so, I had previously recorded this video, and so since the audio didn't pick up, I had to redo it. So yeah, we're gonna do this again. So I'm going to be introducing to you guys the concept of the eight head figure. Okay, so the body is going to be divided into eight different heads. Okay, and so you want to start off drawing the let me zoom in a little bit. Okay, so you want to start off drawing the torso, the top portion of the torso, because it's the center. Okay. And it's like it's kind of like an egg shape, so to say. So the top portion of the torso is divided into two different heads. Okay, so this is one head and this is two head. And one head, can you guess what one head is divided into? It's just divided into one head. That's it. So we're just going to be using that one head here as an example. So this is just one head. Okay. The top portion of the torso is divided into two different heads, so it should be equal to like two of these heads. Okay, the pelvis area should be equal to one head here. Okay, and the legs. Okay, we're gonna be doing the legs. Let's just take care of that first. And if you don't get like the bone placements, don't worry about it. This is just a proportions tutorial. I'll do another video on anatomy and all that stuff. But and it doesn't have to be perfect, because it's just, you know, you're drawing like a fundamental layout. So to recap, one head is equal to one head. The top portion of the torso is equal to two different heads. This portion, okay, the bottom portion where the pelvis is and where the tip of the leg is, or so, is equal to like one head. Okay, that's equal to one head. This portion here, the top portion of the leg, upper leg, it will be equal to two heads, which includes the knee. Okay, so this is like another entity here. Yeah, this thing right here, I'm just gonna circle it. There's like another entity here. This is equal to, again, two heads. And then your bottom leg will be equal to two heads, okay? And so that will be like the general like basis of like the figure. Now, if you were drawing a kid or an adult, the proportions would change a bit, you know. So we're gonna like draw the hands, the arm, I mean. We're gonna draw the arm, so we're gonna come right here. And now, like depending on whether it's a teenager or an adult, or the age will depend on as to rather the elbow here reaches the belly button here or not. But you know, just for simplicity's sake, or just for like the simple human human figure, we're going to come, we're just gonna like draw, stopping from here. So this is like this, the top portion of the arm will be equal to two heads somewhat, but it's lowered a little bit. Okay, so remember that it's equal to two heads, but it's lowered a little bit for the top portion of this arm. Okay, and for your forearm, the same thing. Okay, and you can say like for your forearm, for example, it could just equal to like one head. Okay, yeah. And so if you were to draw your hands, you know, the hands are equal to like your hands are equal to just one head again. Okay, and just to, for like little tips and tricks, like your hand is equal to one head, your forearm is equal to the same length as your foot. Okay, so those are like little tips and tricks, but generally, to, you know, that's the entire that's the concept of this, the eight head figure. Okay, and so if you were to draw a female, for example, so we're doing a male, if you were to draw a female, for example, everything still applies, all these rules here still applies. The only difference is that females have a lot more, they have the bigger hips. Okay, they got the bigger hips. So you would, and they kind of like tamper inward. I'll show you, but yeah, females just have, they have the bigger hips. Okay, the butts, but they got the bigger hips. So this would like just tamper a little bit more here, you know. Yeah, this would just tamper a little bit more. Where the male is like more wide, this would tamper inward a little bit more, and then the pelvis is just, you know, a lot more, is a lot more wider. Okay, sometimes you can also, and all the rules still apply for the female. Sometimes you could like draw your females looking like this. And then have the pelvis area right here elongated, so to say. But yeah, you could choose this as well, but generally follow like the eight head figure and whatnot. What else? And I'll go into another tutorial where I cover the adults, different things to take care of when you're dealing with drawing adults, toddlers, children, etc. But generally, this is like the basis, okay? And for your recap, is this is equal to one head, top torso is equal to two heads. Okay, yeah, top torso is equal to two head, pelvis is equal to one head, this area here is equal to two heads, the top portion of the leg, which includes the knee, is equal to two heads, the bottom portion of the leg is equal to two heads, the this portion here is, you know, is like two heads but a little bit lowered. Okay, a little bit decreased than two heads. Okay, not fully two heads, but it's almost two heads. Okay, this, the forearm, you can say is equal to a head or so. And for your tips or so, your hand is equal to, is the same length, if you were to like spread it out, would be the same length as the head. And your foot would be you know, same length as your forearm. Okay. Sometimes the forearm is like a little bit it's like a tiny bit larger than the head, but it's still generally the same size as the head, but sometimes, but generally it's like a tiny bit larger. And so the foot would be equal to your elbow. I mean your forearm. And consider subscribing to the family. So you can hit that. And don't forget to hit the red bell button for to get notified for when I upload every Saturday. So when you click that, you'll see this. You can click the chat box to send the notifications for you. And then just save it. I also provide you guys a Discord or a place to chat. My Discord will be available in the link down below. I provide references, you know, for anyone that want to, you know, look into it. You know, so I have references for, you know, ears, breasts, you know, front torso, back torso, etc. And including hands as well. And this is where you can, you know, just chat with the family and you can share your artwork here, etc. That's just the basis of the Discord. Check it out, whatnot. And that'll be the video. Thank you guys for watching. Peace out.